السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله وكفى، وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، لا سيما المصطفى صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. My dear viewers, welcome to another episode in our series of Best of the Best. With another Best of the Best, a beautiful hadith authenticated by Sheikh Albani, collected by Imam Tirmidhi, in which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, خير الناس من طال عمره وحسن عمله. The best of all people is the one who lives a long life while his deeds are good. So he lives a long life and he is utilizing his life, his days, his nights, his time in doing what is good to increase the balance of the good deed. The hadith is narrated by عبد الرحمن بن أبي بكرة عن أبيه أن رجلا قال يا رسول الله أي الناس خير. A man came to the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, and said, O Prophet of Allah, which of the people is the best? أي الناس خير. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من طال عمره وحسن عمله. The one whose life is long and his deeds are good. قال فأي الناس شر. Then which of the people is the worst? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من طال عمره وساء عمله. The one who lives a long life, but his deeds are bad. May Allah the Almighty grant us a good life and long life and good deeds. Ameen. So the hadith is not talking about the superiority or the betterness of living a long life and that's it. Rather, it is talking about the best of the best is the one who utilizes his time so that the more he lives, the more he earns good deeds, the more he builds up and piles up a greater asset of good deeds. And the smartest of all is the one who works on continuing earning good deeds even after his death. We all know that al-a'mar, the lifespan of the nations, of the people, of the individuals, is already preordained by Allah the Almighty. So we have nothing to do with it. We cannot increase it, nor can we decrease it. فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهُمْ لَا يَسْتَأْخِرُونَ سَاعَةً وَلَا يَسْتَقَدِمُونَ. Every ummah, every people, and every individual has a fixed term. And once their term is due, they neither stay behind an hour or a moment, nor do they proceed. So before we were born, it is already known to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you're going to live for 60 years. And somebody else will live for 103 years. And a child will die while in the cradle. And another will die in the womb of his or her mother. Okay? So we have nothing to do with that. In addition to, we don't know how long do we live. That is because Allah the Almighty kept the knowledge of how long do we live and the term of every people and every individual only with himself. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. He said in the last verse of Surah Luqman that no soul knows where and when will it die. It is Allah the Almighty indeed who is Al-Alim, the all-knowing, al-khabir, the well-acquainted. And if this is the case, then we and the believers should seize this opportunity of the life and they do their best without postponing, without wasting any time, in order to benefit the maximum benefit out of their lifespan, out of their days and their nights. In order to better explain this hadith, perhaps, and since we are in a blessed month, the month of Ramadan, it is very important to share with you this hadith, which is narrated by one of the great companions, Talha ibn Ubaidillah, may Allah be pleased with him. And the hadith is collected by Imam Ahmad in his Musnad and others. Talha ibn Ubaidillah, who's one of the 10 heaven-bound companions, said, there were two people from the tribe of Balay who have come to the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, and they accepted Islam on the same day. And he described one of the two as much more active in worship than the other. And furthermore, he said that the one who is active in worship more than his friend died also as a shaheed on a battlefield. And we all know that the magnificent reward that Allah the Almighty has prepared for the martyrs. Then a year later, his friend or his brother who accepted Islam with him on the same day happened to die, but a normal death, like on his bed. Then Talha ibn Ubaidillah, may Allah be pleased with him, said that once when I was asleep, I saw them both in a night vision. And three of us were standing in front of the gate of paradise. And one of the guards of heaven stepped out and he called on the one who died later. And he said, come and join me. And he escorted him to paradise. Then a while later, he stepped out and he called on the shaheed and he invited him to join him to enter paradise. When Talha ibn Ubaidillah woke up, he shared this dream with the companions of the Messenger of Allah. And everybody was surprised, everybody was puzzled. And while they were discussing this matter, the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, showed up upon them. And he asked them, what is the matter? So they told him the dream of Talha ibn Ubaidillah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and what is so amazing in that? What is strange? They said, Ya Rasulullah, the companion who died as a shaheed, and everybody witnessed that he was much more active in worship, he's supposed to enter paradise before his friend. Especially the latter one died a normal death. He didn't die as a shaheed. So the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, broke it down to him. He was looking at it from a completely different angle. And this is the catch in explaining this hadith. He said, didn't the one who survived the shaheed or the 1 year later, didn't he live for one complete year? And that means he witnessed a whole month of Ramadan that the shaheed didn't get to witness it. They said, yes, that is true. He said, didn't he get to pray about 6,000 rak'ahs throughout this 1 year which he lived? They said, that is true as well. He said, as a result of that, by Allah, the gap between the two levels of the one who lived for an extra year is greater than the gap between the heavens and the earth. The one who died as a shaheed is blessed and is honored by Allah the Almighty and he entered paradise and all of that. But the other person lived after him for one complete year. During this 1 year, he happened to pray every day, 5 times a day and perhaps plus the 17 rak'ahs, the fard, nawafil, night prayer, duha, witr. Also, he got to pray Taraweeh during Ramadan. In addition to, most importantly, he witnessed a whole month of Ramadan that the shaheed died without witnessing. Because of that, he is superior to the shaheed in the level, and his rank in paradise is way higher than the shaheed. And the gap between them is greater than the gap between the heavens and the earth. It's all about time, brothers and sisters. But it isn't only about time and that's it. It's about how do you utilize your time. What do you do with your time? The time is a capital sum of every living human being. And some people know how to invest in it, how to use it best. And some, unfortunately, they waste their lifetime. And that's why the rest of the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ answered the question when he was asked, and which one of the people is the worst? The Prophet ﷺ said, the worst of all the people is the one who lives a long life while doing bad deeds. May Allah protect us against that. To be continued, inshallah, with some more interesting hadith in this regard after we take a short break. So please stay tuned.
Islam is a way of life. A complete way. It's a complete way.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. Today we're studying together the hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, خير الناس من طال عمره وحسن عمله وشر الناس من طال عمره وساء عمله. The best of all the people is the one who lives a long life and he does good deeds. And the worst of all the people is the one who lives a long life while doing bad deeds, evil deeds. Prophet Ibrahim, peace be upon him, had a beautiful invocation which Allah recounted in the Quran in Surah Al-Shu'ara. He said, وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. He said, my Lord, disgrace me not on the day on which people will be resurrected and gathered. On that day, neither wealth nor children will help or avail an aught. What would only help? مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Only the person who comes to meet Allah with a sound heart, with good deeds, with belief and faith in Allah the Almighty, that is the only thing which will help. That's why we said in the previous segment, the greatest capital sum of a believer is not actually the wealth, and it is not how many children do you have, it is not the business, it's time, it's lifespan. And how do you utilize your time? We also learned that it is not possible physically to increase your lifespan or to change it, since we don't even know how long are we supposed to live. But we have an access to put barakah in our lifespan, so that somebody who have lived only for 50 years and his life is better than somebody who lived for 500 years, or better than a whole nation who lived for 100 years each. Imam al-Shafi'i, may Allah have mercy on him, you know, he lived only for about 50 years. And his life was full of blessings, seeking knowledge, learning, giving fatwa, teaching people. And nowadays, who doesn't know about Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i? May Allah have mercy on him. Al-Imam al-Nawawi, may Allah have mercy on him as well. He died when he was 40 plus. If you check out the books that he authored and the amount of knowledge that he left behind, you would think that this person have lived for hundreds of years. But Allah had put barakah in his time. So those people utilize their time in the best fashion. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though the lifespan is short physically, but due to the fact that there was a lot of barakah and blessings in it, it was worth like living for hundreds of years. Because of that, Al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah said, أَدْرَكْتُ أَقْوَامًا كَانُوا عَلَىٰ أَوْقَاتِهِمْ أَشَدُّ مِنْكُمْ حِرْصًا عَلَىٰ دَرَاهِمِكُمْ وَدَنَانِيرِكُمْ. He said, I have witnessed some people who were very careful with how they spend their time and how they utilize their time, more than you're being careful as how do you spend your money, your dirham, and your dinar. The Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, in a separate hadith, reminded us that we should seize the opportunity of the leisure time that we have, of our health before we turn sick, of our youth before we turn old, of our life before we die. And he said, اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس, seize the opportunity of five before you're being seized by other five. So he spoke about, if you're young, take advantage of your youth. Do lots of ibadah, seek knowledge, help people. Because as you grow old, you won't have an access to do the same. You start losing memory, you get weak, you yourself need help. You cannot stand up and pray anymore, maybe you have to sit down. You won't be able to fast, now you're diabetic, you have renal failure, God forbid. Because as you grow old, also sickness increase and ailment spread in the body and so on. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, warning the believers, نِعْمَتَانِ مَغْبُونٌ فِيهِمَا كَثِيرٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ. There are two blessings which many people, they actually neglect, they're negligent when it comes to utilizing these two blessings. He said, الصِّحَّةُ وَالْفَرَاغُ, health and leisure time. A lot of people don't know what to do with their time. They keep flipping the channels, watching this movie after that movie, the sports, the news. And subhanAllah, a day after another passed by, they say, because I'm retired already, I have nothing to do. Says who? This time which Allah the Almighty blessed you with, He's actually given you this time as an opportunity to pile up a huge balance of good deeds through reading Quran and earning 10 good deeds for each letter you read, seeking knowledge, attending halqas, making dhikr, remembrance of Allah, fast if you can, give any charity, help people by any possible legal means, all of that in order to increase the balance of your good deeds. So, brothers and sisters, how can a person actually, besides, you know, putting barakah in his lifespan, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, that man ahabba an yubsat lahu fi rizqih wa yunsa lahu fi atharih, let him, if a person likes to increase his lifespan and increase his provision, let him uphold the ties of his kinship. فَلْيَصِلُ رَحِمَهُ فَلْيَصِلُ رَحِمَهُ. If you do so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put barakah in your lifespan, so that you will achieve a lot of things that people do not achieve in the double of your lifespan. But because Allah the Almighty blessed you because of this quality of upholding the ties of kinship. Besides that, is there any possible way that I can still continue to earn reward after my life ceases in this worldly life? Yes, of course. As the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, said, whenever the servant of Allah dies, obviously he is not working on his own to earn good deeds anymore. But there are three possible ways through which you can still continue to earn reward even after you die. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam guided us to the continuous charity. And he said, a person who's been teaching people a useful knowledge, he left behind a book that he authored, lectures that he taught, students that he taught. As long as he continued to spread the goodness and teach people goodness, he will continue to receive reward for that even though he's dead. And the third is a righteous child. Investing in your children to bring them to become good, devout worshippers, to become righteous servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to make dua for you after you die, that will continue to bless you and also increase your reward even though you passed away already. Those, on the other hand, who have wasted their lifespan here and there and did not take advantage of this wonderful opportunity that Allah the Almighty blessed them with, they will regret. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتُ قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ. At the time of their death, they would only long for one thing. They would beg Allah the Almighty to give them a respite. Just give us another chance. Take me back to life and I will show you what am I going to do. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِيمَا تَرَكْتُ. Because I promise, I certainly believe I will do better if you give me a respite, if you prolong my life. But Allah the Almighty will answer saying, كَلَّا إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ هُوَ قَائِلُهَا وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. It is just mere wish. It's just a word which is worthless. Because those who die, Allah the Almighty will keep them in the barzakh life, in the grave, in the life between the worldly life and the hereafter until resurrection. وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. Also, on the other hand, some people think that because Allah the Almighty is giving them a long life, this is a sign that He is happy with them. And some of the believers do not realize that this is actually a test from Allah and to increase the torment for those people who've been given respite, but still they did not take heed. So in Surah Al-An'am, chapter number 6, in the two consecutive ayahs 31 and 32, Allah the Almighty has already declared the following. قَدِ خَسِرَ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِلِقَاءِ اللَّهِ حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَتْهُمُ السَّاعَةُ بَغْتَةً قَالُوا يَا حَسْرَتَنَا عَلَى مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِيهَا وَهُمْ يَحْمِلُونَ أَوْزَارَهُمْ عَلَى ظُهُورِهِمْ أَلَا سَاءَ مَا يَزِرُونَ. Those who denied the possibility of meeting Allah in life after death, a resurrection, have indeed encountered the greatest loss. And when the hour, when the day of judgment is established, all of a sudden, they would say to themselves, يَا حَسْرَتَنَا عَلَى مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِيهَا. They would say, woe to us We wasted our life. وَهُمْ يَحْمِلُونَ أَوْزَارَهُمْ عَلَى ظُهُورِهِمْ While they were carrying their evil deeds over their backs. أَلَا سَاءَ مَا يَزِرُونَ How evil is what they are carrying. Then in the following ayah says, in ayah number 32 of the same surah, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَاعِبٌ وَلَهُ وَلَلدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ The life of this world is nothing but joy and play, and the actual life is there in the hereafter. So the life here is simply mere test. People are being tested with the lifespan, with wealth and poverty, with health and sickness. By all means, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً We may try you with what is bad or what is good in order to test you. Then afterward, you will be returned to us. وَلَلدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ And indeed, most certainly, the home of the hereafter in paradise is better. But for the pious ones, أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ Will you not then take heed and ponder over the reminder of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So the scholar said, You're not supposed to make dua for anyone, say, may Allah give you a long life. Because just having a long life does not necessarily mean it's a good thing. So rather you should say, may Allah grant you a good life and good deeds, not just a long life. So brothers and sisters, to all of you, may Allah grant us and you a long life and good deeds. أطال الله أعماركم وأحسن أعمالكم. Until next time, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.